upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived within. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return, by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope, for who could ever learn to love a beast?
Already.
Well, it's my favorite. Far off places, daring sword fights, magic spells, to prince in disguise.
If you like it all that much, it's yours.
But sir...
I insist.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
There she goes, that girl is so peculiar. I wonder if she's feeling well.
With a dreamy far off look.
And her nose stuck in a book.
What a puzzle to the rest of us is there.
Isn't this amazing? It's my-
very different from the rest of us.
She's nothing like the rest of us.
It's different from the rest of us. She's red.
I've got it. I've got it. Wow. You didn't miss a shot, Gaston. You're the greatest hunter in the whole world.
I know.
No beast alive has a chance against you, and no girl for that matter.
It's true, LeFou. I've got my sights set on that one.
The inventor's daughter?
She's the one. The lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she's...
the most beautiful girl in town.
I know,
that
but...
makes her the best. And don't I deserve the best?
Well, of course you do.
But from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fail. Here in town there's only she who's beautiful as me. So I'm making plans to woo and marry Pale.
Look, there he goes, isn't he dreamy? Monsieur Gaston, oh, he's so cute!
Excuse me. Please let me through.
Doesn't quite fit in.
But she really is a funny girl. A beauty but a funny girl. She really is a funny girl.
Book back, please.
How can you read this? There's no pictures.
Well, some people use their imagination.
Belle, it's about time you got your head out of these books and started paying attention to more important things.
Hint, hint.
Like you.
Exactly. The whole town's talking about it, and it's simply not right for a woman to read. Soon she starts getting ideas and thinking.
Gaston, you're positively primeval.
Why, thank you, Belle. What do you say you and me take a walk over to the tavern and take a look at my trophies?
What do you say? We don't...
Come on, Belle. I think I know how you feel about me.
You can't even imagine. Gaston, please, I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool. He needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius. Papa!
Some genius.
What's a genius? How?
Now, LeFou, I want you to go out into the woods and bring me back the biggest deer you can find.
Not the woods. Anything but the woods. You know I hate the woods.
Just get me a deer for my wedding feast.
I hate the woods. It's dark and spooky, and there's bugs and spiders.
Papa, are you all right?
I'm fine, but I can't for the life of me figure out why this happened. This isn't the stubbornest piece of... Oh!
Papa!
I'm about ready to give up on this hunk of junk.
Oh, you always say that.
I mean it this time. I'll never get this boned contraption to work.
Yes, you will. And you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
Of course I do. I always have.
Well, we'd better get cracking. This thing's not going to fix itself. Now let me see. Where did I put the dog leg clencher?
Papa. Oh.
So tell me, did you have a nice time in town today?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Well, they take me away to these wonderful places where there's adventure and mystery and romance and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My daughter. Odd? Now, where would you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just that, well, people talk.
They talk about me, too. No, I'm not Todd nor you. No family ever saner, except one uncle who will maybe let that pass. In all you say and do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud. I love the funny way you stand out from the crowd.
It's my intention, my invention shows the world out there one day just what we've got, no matter what. Now some may say your fathers just exaggerate,
that every daughter's great.
But you are.
And every daughter tends to say her father stops.
She pulls out all the stops to praise him.
And quite rightly.
No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing best.
And daughter too.
You're never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're all I've got, no matter what. Now what do you say we give her a try?
All right.
You get the logs. All right. Stand back. Here we go.
It works! It works!
It does! It does!
Papa, you did it! You really did it! You'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. I know it!
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
Oh, I almost forgot. I made you a scarf for good luck.
Now I know I'll win. And when I do, we'll leave this town and go to all those places you read about in your books. Well, I'm off.
Goodbye, Papa.
Goodbye, Belle.
Be careful.
First prize is nearly mine. It's quite my best invention. So simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is, providing I can find the fair at all. I must have missed a sign. I should have paid attention. That's not a nightingale and not a mating call. Whoa! Stay back! Stay! Hello? Hello?
Well, now you've done it. I told you not to let him in. We could not leave him for the wolves.
Is anyone home?
If we keep quiet, maybe he'll go away.
Is anyone here?
Not one word, Lumiere. Not one word.
I don't mean to intrude, but I've lost my way in the woods and I need a place to stay for the night.
Ah, poor fellow. Ah, Cogsworth, have a heart.
Messieurs, you are welcome here.
I heard that. I know there's someone here, and I'll thank you for you to come out where I can see you.
Allo? Allo?
And goodbye!
No, wait! You're a clock, and you're talking!
Astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye.
Cogsworth! I am surprised at you. Where are your manners?
We've got to get him out of here before the master finds out.
This is incredible. How is this accomplished?
Ow! Stop that! Really, sir? Do you mind?
Well, I'm stumped. Maybe some kind of new scientific gadget.
I, sir, am not a gadget!
I beg your pardon. I didn't mean to be rude. It's just... I've never seen a talking to a
Bless you!
Sure, chill to the bone, monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, I forbid it! As head of this household, I demand you to... not the master's chair! I'm not seeing this!
Ooh la la, what have we here? Do my eyes deceive me? Or is that a man? Oh, it's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lumiere. Bonjour, monsieur. You don't mind if I sit here, do you?
Oh, well, hello.
All right. This has gone far enough.
Coming
I'm
through.
In charge here and...
Thank you. How would you like a nice cup of tea, sir? It will warm you up in no time.
Oh, yes, please.
No tea. You'll be all night here.
There you are.
Thank you. This is just what I need. Hi there, little...
I think I scared him, Mama.
Hi there, little fella. What's your name?
Chip.
Figures.
Carefully blanket, monsieur. Oh, I just love older men.
Babette! You are always trying to make me jealous. Well, it's not going to work this time.
Me? What about you with Simon?
Jacques?
Michel?
Pierre?
Veronique?
Oh, Veronique. Voilà.
Lumiere! We've got to get him out of here. Do you have any idea what the master will do to us if
Calm
he finds out?
Calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never have to know. As I was saying, he was bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide, Mama?
No. Remain calm. There is absolutely no reason to panic.
Yes. Lumiere is right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. May I borrow this?
There's a stranger here.
Master, allow me to explain. See, the gentleman was set upon by the wolf and who's...
Who let him in?
Master, may I take this opportunity to say I was against it from the start.
Who dare disobey me?
Oh, dear.
You have all betrayed me. Who are you?
Maurice.
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the
You're not welcome here!
Okay, I'll just be on my way.
It's hideous, isn't it?
No, I wasn't. No, I wasn't.
You've come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I was merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay!
It's so... Girls, I'm just getting married. Don't tell me a little thing like that's gonna change your feelings for me.
No, no,
never.
And we'll still have our little rendezvous, won't we?
Yes.
Of course,
always.
Good. Well, if we're gonna have a wedding, I guess I'd better propose to the bride. run along now. Belle? Oh, Belle? Anyone home? Hello?
Gaston, what a pleasant surprise.
Isn't it, though? I'm just full of surprises. For you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait of you. You shouldn't have.
Don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who wouldn't love to be in your shoes. This is the day your dreams come true.
What could you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Plenty. Been dreaming just one dream nearly all your life, hoping, scheming just one theme. Will you be a wife? Will you be some he-man's property? Good news, that he-man's me. This equation, curl plus man, doesn't just help you. On occasion, women can have their uses too, mainly to extend the family tree. Pumpkin, extend with me. We'll be raising sons galore.
Inconceivable.
Each built 6'4".
Unbelievable.
Each one stuffed with every Gaston gene.
I'm not hearing
You'll
this.
You'll be keeping house with pride.
Just incredible.
Each day gratified.
So unwettable.
That you are part of this idyllic scene. Picture this. A rustic hunting lodge. My latest kill roasting over the fire. My little wife massaging my feet, while the little ones play on the floor with the dogs. Oh, we'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, Belle, strapping boys like me.
Imagine that.
I can see that we will share all that love implies. We shall be the perfect pair, rather like my thighs. You are face to face with destiny. All roads lead to the best things in life are all's well that ends with me. Escape me, there's no way, certain as Dore, Belle, when you marry. So, Belle, what'll it be? Is it a yes? Or is it oh yes?
I just don't deserve you.
Who does? Me!
But thanks for asking. So, how'd it go?
You know that, Belle, always playing hard to get.
She turned you down?
For now. But I'll have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
So if she turned him down,
that means I still have a chance.
No!
Is he gone? Can you believe it? He asked me to marry him. Me, the wife of that boorish, brainless Madame Gaston. Can you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife. No, sir, not me. I guarantee it. I want much more than this provincial life. to have someone understand. I want so much more than they've got planned.
Hey, Belle! Have you seen Gaston?
You just missed him. Wait, where did you get this scarf?
This? In the woods. Pretty nice, huh?
This belongs to my father.
Yeah, well, finders keepers.
LeFou, I want you to think hard and tell me exactly where you found this.
No.
Think.
Somewhere in the woods.
Harder.
Ow, near the crossroads, okay?
He's still out there somewhere. LeFou, you have to take me back.
Not the woods again.
Don't you see? Something must have happened to him. You have to take me back.
Not on your life.
Well, then I'll find him myself.
Couldn't keep quiet, could we? Just had to invite him to stay, didn't we? Serve him tea, sit in the master's chair.
I was trying to be hospitable.
Rubbish!
Ah, Cogsworth. Can't you blame me for trying to maintain what is left of our humanity? Look at us.
Look at you.
What about me?
You always were insufferable. But every day, you become a little more inflexible. A little more tightly wound. A little more ticked off.
Please, spare me the stupid puns.
Look, at least we are not as far gone as some of the others. You saw what happened to Michelle.
She always was too vain about her looks.
Yes.
And that's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
Little drawers, mirror, the works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
Jean-Claude. You remember him, not too bright, dumbass.
A brick.
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall.
That's him in the kitchen behind the stove. And do you remember Guillaume, the houseboy?
That mealy-mouthed bootlicker! I've never liked him! He's always groveling at the master's feet!
He's a doormat.
Perfect!
It's happening faster with some of the others. But we are not far behind.
Slowly but surely, as every day passes, we will all gradually become things.
But why did we have to get dragged into this whole spell business? It's not like we threw that poor beggar woman out on her ear.
No, but are we not responsible too for helping make him the way that he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is I will eventually melt away
to nothing.
I only hope there's something left of me if the master ever breaks the spell.
We've got to hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
He's a girl!
Yes, I can see it's a girl.
He's a girl! Mademoiselle!
No, now, Lumiere, let me do all the talking.
You!
No, as head of this household, I should do most of the talking.
Sherry!
No, Lumiere, no. What? No, no, Lumiere! One word, just one word.
Mama, you're not gonna believe what I saw. Not in a million thousand years. Not in a trillion million thousand years.
Yes, Chip.
No, really, this is the greatest thing. It's a thing that everybody's been waiting for since I don't know when.
All right, Chip, what is it?
There's a girl in the castle.
Oh, well, bless my soul. Now, wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is. I saw her.
Now, Chip, I'll not have you running around making up wild stories, getting everyone's hopes up for no reason.
Mrs. Potts, did you hear? There's a girl in the castle.
See? I told you, and she's real pretty, too.
Well, I wouldn't know about that.
This is a word that girl we have been waiting for. She has come to break the spell, come to break the spell.
Now, Lumia, let's not be hasty.
Oh, isn't it wonderful? After all these years, happy, happy day.
No.
We should tell the others. Now, let's go.
Yes. No! I mean, no! Lumiere, wait a minute!
Hello? Is anyone here? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Bill?
Papa!
How did you find me?
Your hands are like ice. We have to get you out of here.
Belle, you must leave
this
place. Who's
done this to you?
There's no time to explain. You must go,
I
now.
I won't leave you here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one responsible for this. Release my father at once.
I am the master of this castle. I do not take orders from anyone! Get out!
No, wait. Please let him out. Can't you see he's not well?
Then he should not have trespassed here.
But he's an old man! He could die!
He came into my home uninvited, and now he'll suffer the consequences!
Please, I'll do anything!
Bill!
There's nothing you can do.
Wait, please.
I said, there's nothing you can do!
Take me instead.
No!
What did you say?
Take me instead.
Belle, you don't know what you're doing. Please!
You would do that. You would take his place.
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes, but you must promise to stay here. Forever.
No!
Forever?
Forever! Or he dies in the dungeon!
That's not fair! Wait. Come into the light.
Make your choice.
Belle, listen to me. I'm old. I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Done!
No!
Belle,
wait!
Please spare my daughter!
Take him to the crossroads!
Master, please. Since the girl is going to be with us for quite some time, you might want to offer her a more comfortable room?
You didn't even let me say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again, and I didn't even get to say goodbye.
I'll take you to your room.
My room, but I...
Do you want to stay in the dungeon?
No.
Then follow him. This is your home now. You're free to go anywhere you like. Except the West Wing.
Why?
What's... It's forbidden. You're never to set foot there. Do you understand?
Yes.
This is your room. I hope you'll be comfortable here. If you need anything, my servants will attend you. And one more thing. You will join me for dinner. That is not a request!
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster! If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think again. Is this home? Is this where I should learn to be happy? Be dark and cold. I was told every day in my childhood, even when we grow old, home should be where the heart is. Never were words so true. My heart's far.
Dear, I thought you might like some tea.
Come in.
You know, there's nothing like a cup of tea to make the world seem a bit brighter, if I don't say so myself.
But you're a...
Mrs. Potts, dear, very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Ooh! Careful, dearie! Who are you? My name is Madame de la Grande Bouche. You must have heard of me.
Sorry.
You see, they've all forgotten about me. One can be, and I quote, the toast of Europe, the brightest star to ever grace the stage, but fall under one little spell.
Shh, wait. This is impossible.
I know it is, but here we are. Ah, well, what shall we dress you in for dinner, dearie? This is nice, but let's see what I've got in my drawer, shall we? Ooh, not that. Ah, there it is. This is the dress I wore the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. Of course, I wouldn't have a prayer fitting into it now. Take it.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
No, of course you are. Don't be silly. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry, this is all just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm gonna miss my father so much.
Oh, cheer up, child. I know things may seem bleak right now, but you mustn't despair. We're here to see you through. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then Belle, it's you.
anything. She is! That girl has tangled with the wrong man.
Darn right.
No one says no to Gaston. Dismissed. Rejected. Publicly humiliated. It's more than I can bear.
Beer?
What for nothing helps when disgraced?
Who, you? Never. Gaston, you've got to pull yourself together.
Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dumps. Every guy here'd like to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy. Everyone's awed and inspired by you, and it's not very hard to see why. No one's slick as Gaston, no one's quick as Gaston, no one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston. Well, there's no man in town half as manly. Perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they'd prefer to be on.
No one's thin like Gaston, a kingpin like Gaston.
No one's got a swell cleft in his chin like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating.
But what a guy like Gaston. Give 5 hurrahs, give 12 pimp pimps.
Gaston is the best and the rest are all drips.
No one fights like Gaston, does his life like Gaston.
In a wrestling match, nobody bites like Gaston.
There's no one as curly and brawny.
As you see, I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every less inch of me's covered with hair.
No one fits like Gaston, matches wits like Gaston.
In a spitting match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating to it.
10 points for Gaston.
When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. And now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size of a porch.
Help! Help!
Maurice?
Please, help me! He's got her! He's got her locked in a dungeon!
Who?
Belle, we must go at once. There's not a minute to lose.
Whoa, slow down, Maurice. Who's got Belle locked in a dungeon?
A beast. A horrible, monstrous beast!
Is it a big beast?
Huge!
With spooky yellow eyes?
Yes, yes.
With a long, ugly snout?
Hideously ugly.
And sharp, cruel fangs?
Yes, yes. Will you help me? Please, will you help me?
All right, old man.
Thank you.
We'll help you. Out!
All right, I'll go back there and get her out myself.
Crazy old Maurice.
Always good for a laugh.
Crazy old Maurice. Crazy old Maurice. With whom I'm afraid I've been thinking.
A dangerous pastime.
I know. But that wacky old fruit is Bell's father, and his sanity's only so-so. Now the wheels in my head have been turning since I looked at that loony old man. See, I'd promised myself I'd be married to Bell, and right now I'm evolving a plan. If I?
Yes?
Then we?
No, would she?
Yes.
Now I get it.
Let's go.
No one laughs like Gaston,
take cheap shots like Gaston,
plans to persecute harmless crackpots like Gaston.
Yes, I'm endlessly wildly resourceful,
as down to the depths you descend.
I won't even be mildly remorseful,
just as long as you get what you want in the end.
Who has brains like Gaston?
Entertained like Gaston.
Who can make up these endless refrains like Gaston?
So his marriage we soon will be celebrating. My, what a guy, Gaston.
Is dinner ready, Mrs. Potts?
Just about. I have the foggiest idea what she likes to eat, so I've cooked up everything in the kitchen.
Good, good. Yes? Well, don't just stand there gaping. Get back to work.
You tell him.
I can't.
Tell me what?
Now, don't get upset, but you have something on your back!
What on earth are you talking about?
Come. Look.
What is it?
It appears to be a winding handle of sorts.
Well, get it off of me!
Okay. Stay still. No, it won't come off.
What do you mean it won't come off? It wasn't there last night when I went to bed. Where did it come from? And why is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
Just try to relax.
Relax?
Yes.
Relax?
Uh-huh.
How can I relax with this appendage on my back? Is there no dignity left for me? And what's going to go next? My mind?
You go. Calm yourself, Cogsworth. It will all be all right.
I'm frightened, Lumiere.
Oh, I know, my friend. But you are not alone.
We're all in this together.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
Perhaps I should go see about her. It won't be a minute.
I told her to calm down. What's taking her so long?
Try to be patient, sir. Remember, she has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you ever thought that perhaps this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I'm not a fool.
Good. So you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, the spell is broken. We'll be human again by midnight.
Now, Lumiere, of course you know it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use.
She's so beautiful, and I'm... Well, look at me.
He has a point.
Shh. But Master, you must help us see past all of that.
I don't know how.
Well... yes. Well, you could use some work. Okay. First, you can start by trying to make yourself more presentable. Straighten up. Try to act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your happier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere. And above all...
what?
You must control your temper.
Well? What? Where is she?
Who? Yes, the girl. Well, she's in the process of circumstances being what they are. She's not coming.
Huh?
She's not coming?
What did you say?
She's not coming!
We'll see about that!
Lordship, your grace, let's not be hasty.
Stay where you are. Lumiere, stand aside. I thought I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I'm telling you to come to dinner.
And I'm telling you I'm not hungry.
You're hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't go around ordering people and telling them to be hungry. It doesn't work like that. Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude is it? Then how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I will grab you by the...
Master! That may not be the best way to win the girl's affection.
Please, attempt to be a gentleman.
But why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come to dinner.
So you admit you're being a bully.
Deep breath, Master. Deep breath.
I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind? Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please.
No. Thank you.
Fine, then, Star!
Master, please!
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all!
What were we thinking? We'll never be human again!
So it appears.
Well, what would you two have us do? Give up?
Yes.
No! I can't! I can't give up until I hear the sound of my boy's laughter as he runs through these halls again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give up while there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand watch at the door, and if there's the slightest movement, inform me at once.
Oui, mon capitaine.
I ask nicely, but she refuses. What does she want me to do? Beg? Show me the girl.
Look, I know the master can be a bit temperamental, but underneath all that matted fur, he's not such a bad fellow. Why don't you give him a chance?
Did he give my father a chance?
Well, no. But once you get to know him...
I don't want to get to know him. I don't want to have anything to do with him. Oh.
I'm just fooling myself. She'll never see me as anything. But a monster. How long must this go on? This cruel trick of fate. I simply made one careless wrong decision. And when that witch was gone and left me in this state, an object of revulsion and derision, hated, is there no one who can show me how to win the world's forgiveness? No!
What did they say? Shower her with compliments. Impress her with your wit. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentle man.
Lumiere? Oh, Lumiere.
Oh, Babette! Come to me, my little fluff.
Oh, it's my hands, isn't it? You don't love me anymore. Oh, it's this horrible spell.
Achoo! Ah, chérie, you got me to the wick. Now you really...
You call my fancy.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh no, 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 no.
Oh yes.
Oh no, 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 no.
Oh yes.
I've been burnt by you before. Oh, stop it.
Yeah.
Actually, madame, I am a bit hungry.
Oh, I'll ring for Mrs. Potts and see you an aria while we wait.
That's all right. I'll go myself.
But what about the master? Oh, he's not going to like this.
I know.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
I like this girl. I like her spark.
Well, if you ask me, she was just being stubborn. After all, he did say please.
You know, I think that may be the first time I've heard him use that word.
I believe you're right.
You see? She's already starting to have a positive influence on him. Oh, there you are, dearie. Nice to see you out and about.
I am Cogsworth. Head of the household.
Cogsworth! Ah! The girl! She is gone, I swear! My eyes never left the home! Enchanté, mademoiselle.
This is Lumiere. No, 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 no! Stop that! If there is anything we can do to make your stay more comfortable, anything at all.
I am a bit hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth!
Oh, you heard what the master said.
Oh, pish posh. I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine. One glass of water, one crust of bread.
Cogsworth! Where are your manners? She is not a prisoner. She's our guest. And we must make her feel welcome here.
All right. Dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our necks.
Of course, of course. But what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you here tonight. And now we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest, be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie a napkin around your neck, cherie, and we'll provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvres. Why we only live to serve? Try the great stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is France. And the dinner here is never second best. Go on, unfold your menu, take a glance, and then you'll be our guest. Oh, our guest, be our guest.
Beef ragu, cheese souffle, pie and pudding en flambé.
We'll prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one's gloomy or complaining while the flatware's entertaining.
We tell jokes,
I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all in perfect taste as you can bear.
Come on in. If you're stressed, it's fine dining, we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest. Be our guest, get your worries off your chest. Let us stay for digest. Try the bread, try the soup, or the croutons of the loop.
It's a treat for any diner, don't believe me, as in China.
Singing pork, dancing veal, what an entertaining meal. How could anyone be gloomy or depressed? We'll make them shout and send us out for more. So be our guest, be our guest.
So unnerving for a servant who's not serving. He's not old without a soul to wait upon. As those good old days when we were useful, suddenly those good old days are gone. 10 years we've been hustling, needing so much more than dusting, needing exercise, a chance to use our skill. Most days we just play around the castle. Flabby, fat, and lazy, you've acted. Oopsie daisy. Achoo!
For dinner. It was
Good job, good show, good show, everybody. Oh my goodness, look at the time! Off to bed, off to bed!
Oh, I couldn't possibly go to bed now. It's my first time in an enchanted castle.
Enchanted? Who said anything about being enchanted? It was you, wasn't it?
I figured it out myself. I'd like to take a look around, if that's all right.
Perhaps you would like a tour.
No, I'm not sure that's such a good idea. We can't have you-know-who poking around you-know-where, if you know what I mean.
Perhaps you'd like to take me. I'm sure you know everything there is to know about the castle.
Well, actually, I do. May I point your attention to our hand-painted ceilings, complete with cherubs frolicking in delight amidst nymphs and centaurs?
Act like a gentleman. 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 This'll be good. Belle? Belle?
Now! If you will note the unusually inverted archways, you will see that this is yet another example of a late neoclassic Baroque period. And as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it! Well, may I point your attention to our flying buttresses above the aviary, which are not as...
Oh, Lumiere, it's all so beautiful! I had no idea! If only he weren't here.
Oh. Act like a gentleman. I'm nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted. And that was the last time a stone of that weight was quarried in this area.
What's up there?
Nothing! Nothing at all in the West Wing.
Ah, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder what he's hiding up there.
Hiding? What an idea, hiding.
Well, then it wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back to...
Maybe later.
Perhaps you would like to see the gardens or the library.
You have a library?
With books.
Oh, yes. Scats of books, mountains of books, forests of books.
Books with pictures, books with words.
More books than you could ever read in a lifetime.
More books by every author who ever set pen to papier.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing here?
I thought
I told you to never come here.
I know, but...
Do you realize what you could have done? You have no right. No right.
Don't touch me. Promise or no promise, I won't stay here.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't mean to frighten you. You don't understand. There's so little left of me. So little left. And in my twisted face, there's not the slightest trace of anything that even hints at kindness. And from my tortured shape, no comfort, no escape. I see, but deep within is utter blindness, hopeless. As my dream dies, as the time flies, love a lost illusion, helpless. And driven to this sad conclusion. No beauty could move me, no goodness improve me, no power on earth if I can't love. Could reach me, no lesson could teach me how I could have loved her and make her love me too if I can't love her. Then who? Long ago I should have seen all the things I could have been. Careless and unthinking, I moved on. She sets me free, but it's not to be if I can't love.